Here's what you need to make this center of your focal point. You need the jumbo grommets. These scared me at first, and I'm just looking forward to using them again in another project because they are fun to use. You need the middle size of the circle rhinestone brads, and you need, this one's a latte button, but any of our designer buttons will work. First, let's start with that middle-sized rhinestone brad. I took the prongs and straightened them out so that they're separated and pretty much straight. Then I gently push them through the button holes or the thread holes of the button. Now you want to be careful because these holes are just a little bit too small to put that brad through, but they will go through. You do not want your prongs to buckle, so be gentle. And when I've got it almost all the way through, that's when I seem to have a little problem. So then I'll get a wire pliers, or maybe raid your husband's toolbox and get some pliers, and then I pull them through one at a time, first one side, then the other, until they pull through. Once the prongs are pulled all the way down into the button where you want it, place the button onto the grommet and then open up the prongs so that they'll hold on. Now, you want to make sure that they're in the right spot and that they're clearing those little prongs from the grommet. Then I rolled up a glue dot and put it behind the prongs so that that would hold them to the grommet. And if they come out, fine. You just don't want it on the outside of the grommet. If it helps hold it down, great. Now I'm going to place the finished piece onto the front of my focal point. Place that on top of one of our mats and push with my finger into the cardstock. And that's going to leave little dots that you really can't see here. So you've got to get one of our paper piercers. And believe me, they are the best paper piercers. I have small hands and they're weighted just perfectly. And if you have larger hands, they'll work for you too. It's just a nice size. And what I did was wherever the prongs left an indentation, I just used the paper piercer to go and make the holes a little bit larger, because that way it's easy for me to go and push the jumbo grommet through and then use your bone folder to push the prongs one way or the other so that they will latch on. And here is your finished focal point. Use some Stampin' Dimensionals, pop it on the front of your card, and you are done. How impressive and so easy.